This week on Maker Update, an e-ink computer you can actually use, a mill that's anything but run-of-the-mill, fluid dynamics in your hand, and how to shovel without breaking your back. Hello and welcome back to Maker Update, the show where we keep you up to date on all the cool things that makers are making. I'm Tyler Weingartner and I hope you're all doing great. We've got an amazing show for you, so let's kick it off with the project of the week. For a while now, we've had the ability to create our own tech with 3D printing, custom PCBs, and programmable electronic platforms like Arduino and Raspberry Pi. But it's not every day that you see a home-built DIY pocket computer. That is until you see this video by Ashtf. This is a custom PDA that's the size of his hand, complete with a keyboard, battery, and a hybrid e-ink and OLED display. That display deserves a special mention because it's a really clever implementation. E-ink is great for battery life since it can hold its display without drawing additional power. But it's not great for moment-to-moment interaction because the refresh rate is so slow. That's where the OLED comes in. It's a small screen just above the keyboard, and it shows the current word you're typing. When you hit space to move to the next word, it commits the new word to the e-ink display. The brains of this operation is an ESP32S3 on a custom PCB that also drives the display and hosts a removable battery and charging circuit. The PCB also provides the input for the keyboard via an array of tactile dome switches. The physical design also deserves a special mention. The housing is made from 3D printed clear resin that lets you see all the components. He didn't print it himself, but ordered it custom made from JLC PCB. But it looks almost indistinguishable from an injection molded part. The membrane keyboard is cast from silicone using this 3D printed mold. From the custom software, the PCB design, the removable battery, the unique display, there's just so much to this project that I haven't seen before. And while the clamshell design makes it into a perfect, pocketable piece of tech, the software will continue to be a work in progress. In the meantime, it's so impressive to see something like this come from a single person's workbench. He's been working on this one for a while, and he has several videos covering its evolution. You can see the full story unfold by following the links down in the description. More projects. I know I said that Chris Borge made his magnum opus of filling 3D prints with concrete when he made his 3D printed lathe. But he's taken that concept even further with this 3D printed CNC mill. True to his traditional design, this is a thin-walled 3D printed form that's been structurally shored up by a number of crisscrossing sections of threaded rod. The X and Y axis ride along on linear rails and are driven by lead screws. However, the Z axis is like one I've never seen before. At first glance, it looks like it's raised and lowered by this cantilevered design. But in reality, it's positioned by another lead screw. Instead, this sliding mechanism houses a counterweight to balance the weight of the spindle, easing the effort of the Z-axis motor. It's a great design that really gives the mill a unique look. The mill can be built for around $300 USD, but Chris isn't releasing the files just yet. There's a few more elements of the design he would like to refine, but it's on the roadmap, so keep an eye on his channel for those to drop. In his quest of creating small form factor interactive matrices, Mitxela has created this fully self-contained fluid simulation pendant. And the degree to which he's rolled his own with this project is really impressive. While his fluid simulation is based on the open source flip algorithm used in software like Blender, he wrote his own version of it based on the creator's original notes. And his charlieplexed arrangement of LEDs is also his own design. It's impressive stuff. And Martina from NerdForge is making her first custom rug, and it's a big one. A 4x4 meter tapestry inspired by the film Howl's Moving Castle. This is an older project, but I just caught wind of it recently, and it's a stunner. When I say it's her first rug project, I mean it. She's never used a tufting gun before. She creates a smaller design as a chance to hone her craft, but the scale of this project is just incredible. I hope we all have the courage to tackle unknown projects this big in the coming year. Time for some tips and tools. If Chris's 3D printed mill got you inspired to use concrete as a material, then this video by LAO2 Academy on making 3D printed molds for concrete will seal the deal. This video takes you through the whole process from the original 3D printed parts, the three-part mold, casting, every step. It's amazing. I recently learned about Stephen Hawes from this video by Becky Stern. And he has a fantastic video on prototyping circuits using fiber lasers. And I know that fiber lasers aren't the most accessible tools, but they've become a lot more available in the past few years. This process only works on FR1 copper clad boards, but it's a great step in homebrew custom circuit boards. BPS Space has a great video on the mindset of approaching and finishing projects, particularly when doing work for hire for outside contractors. In particular, he's focusing on how your creative output can be mitigated by influences outside of your control, and whether or not the project will ever see the light of day, and how that affects your interest in taking on similar projects in the future. I haven't ever worked in government or defense contracting spaces, but I've had similar experiences in the corporate sector, and there's a lot of great lessons in here. And from Gareth's Tips, Tools, and Shop Tales newsletter, we have another great collection of shop tips. From Project Farm, there's a proper drill down, no pun intended, of step drill bits, as well as this video by the Essential Craftsman on the basic task of shoveling, the right shape of the shovel, and the best technique for getting the work done with minimal fatigue. Check it out. For this week's DigiKey Spotlight, the TomorrowLab crew are building a suitcase synthesizer out of components from the Arduino Plug-in Make kit. Arduino Plug-in Make introduces modulinos, small modules for input and output, similar to the Quick or Stemma connection standard. This is a super portable design with a foldable enclosure that creates its own stand. The design allows you to bolt in your own arrangement of modulinos with a mounting board that matches the regular mounting hole spec of the boards, and as long as they're close together, they're easy to wire up. A capacitive touch PCB makes the keyboard and the circuit is complete. It's a fun video. Check it out for more details. All right, and that is gonna do it for this week's show. A reminder, as always, you can get more info about every single one of these projects by following the links down in the description. While you're there, give us a thumbs up, leave us a comment, and hit subscribe so you won't miss the next one. Huge thanks, as always, to DigiKey for making this show possible and to you for watching. Take care, we'll see you soon.